All right, well, I like you as far away from me as you can be.
Okay.
Reminiscing PT and OZ. We don't know what we're reminiscing about. We're just both getting fucking old. That's all it's to it.
Getting. Already been there and done that.
I've been working on my house, and I can't seem to get anything right with it. And anyway.
Well, I tried to make a couple of CDs up for Chuck for that little birthday party he's having. Now he switched it to Sunday. And I didn't have any music CD blanks, so I ordered a 10-pack. Well, I went through 6 or 7 of them, and my stupid burner won't get to the end, finalized. Nope, incomplete. So I finally just duped the mini disc and said, here's a mini disc player, plug it in and go for it.
I don't know why you didn't do it in the first place, but anyway.
I don't know either, but
that way you get 180 songs on there and just plug it in and let it do its thing.
Yeah.
I could have made you up a CD at home that you'd make a rep on the computer.
I don't know. I guess Sony's just about had us that 5-disc changer.
Yeah, that's nobody makes them that way anymore.
No. I got another one downstairs. It was the one I originally...
Nobody listens to CDs anymore.
I know. I originally...
Should have made them a flash drive to plug it in and let it do its thing.
I had the other one up there. That was the original one. And I bought the one I got up there now for a backup just because it was cheap.
Yeah.
But the inputs in the back, one of them got... You know, if I'm going in and out, back and forth, am I using the mini disc or am I using the CD for my source? The connection's just got to be soldered back there. So lazy me, I pulled it out and put the one up there that I bought online. And it works just fine until I just tried to, burn the CDs. But I did have the other one do that a couple times, too. So yeah. I guess, like you said, CDs, who does CDs?
Well, anyway. I got those speakers from the radio station, and they, like I say, they've got a place in the back. You can hook a flash drive to it, and
well, they all
set to go. I know, that's what I mean.
See those the ones you bought, like mine. Mm-hmm. They got the new one. They got the same thing,
right?
The Bluetooth or the USB port.
Yep, Bluetooth too. Yeah, right. Exactly. Yeah. Okay.
I was going to show you that because they've got them on the PSSL catalog came in, and they've got them in there, and Behringer's got some cheap ones in there.
With that little stand I bought, that little speaker stand that I bought, has a radio in it and hookup.
Wrong.
That has Bluetooth too. You don't blow it, you got to go humming it. Other way. You just don't have any hum. There you go. All right, so hey, this is our big tribute for Greg Allman, right?
I don't know it.
Well, we got some Greg Allman stuff. I mean, he was 69. That's young.
Was he?
Yeah. And I saw Greg Allman, believe it or not, I saw Greg Allman with Stan. Big Stan.
Big Stan?
Yeah, way back in, I don't know how many years in the 80s it was anyway. But it was Greg Allman. He was the opening act, and 38 Special was... the other, and it was at the L.C. Walker Arena in Muskegon.
Okay.
Years ago.
Must have been.
Of course, he was married to Cher. We know that. They had a kid named Elijah Blue.
Okay.
Yeah, hey, you're laughing at him. He's got more money than we do. But anyway.
Okay.
Should we play a song?
Well, I got Midnight Rider. That was
all right. That's a great song.
That was my favorite song by him.
Yeah, Dwayne Allman, of course, was a guitar player, and he died years ago.
On the Midnight Rider.
Well, hopefully, it sounds better than that.
No, it doesn't.
All right. Well, so we're doing the 45s. Are you going to put it on or what?
I did
do
put
want,
it on.
Oh, you want me to do it
what,
now?
What, are you just going to sit there? Or you? Well, wait a minute. We got to get the turntable going.
Yeah, get the thing cranking up.
Let that thing sit there for a minute.
Yeah.
I like the other ones, though. It shows you on the side there whether it's going the right speed.
Yeah.
You know, those little dots?
Yeah.
Yeah. Does that look like it's
turning? Yeah, I think so. I think it's 45.
Okay.
Anyway, here's Greg Allman, Allman Brothers Band, right?
Yeah. Just Greg Allman.
Oh, Greg Allman. Yeah. Okay. So I'm right.
a long song.
Ain't gonna let it get me, no. Ain't gonna let it get me, no.
Midnight Rider.
No, oh, that's a beautiful camera there. See that one right over there? Right over there.
What, that one over
there?
Yeah,
that one over there. Not even getting you, is it?
No, it hasn't got me on there at all.
Okay, what about this one over here? Oh, that one gets me, too. It's all me. It's all me today. I like that.
Okay, I'm gone.
And that, but that's that camera. That actually looks good.
I know. What happened?
It looked like crap last week. Oh, well, anyway, we'll do this one.
Thanks for keeping me in the picture.
Hey, no problem. I always like keeping in the picture because I like that little girl's butt behind your head there. She's probably not a little girl anymore. She's probably dead. She's probably like her in the 80s, but anyway.
4 minutes and 26 seconds. I never played this. This is a good condition. This thing's in good condition, yeah. Too. Multicolored Lady. It's almost 5 minutes long. I've never heard that.
All right. Well, sure. Let's do it. Greg Allman. Why not?
What it sounds like. And I got your other one over here. I'm No Angel or whatever.
Oh, yeah. That's one of my favorites by Greg Allman.
But
I like Jessica. I like Melissa by the Allman Brothers.
Melissa, something like that.
Good stuff.
Well, I got a bunch of... The rest of them are the band together.
Okay.
Anyways, here you go. Whatever this is.
If it ever starts. One of these days... I think it's coming. I think it's one of those creepers.
That's why it's 5 minutes long.
Ah. I'm really getting into this already.
I got on the bus in Memphis, destination Rome. Home. I sat next to a broken hearted bed. She was crying, trying so hard to hide her selfish sorrow. I tried to get her talking. Didn't have much to say. Asked me for a map to Death Row, but I didn't know the way. She had lost a million in the game. Wouldn't look out my window at the pine trees in the rain. It wasn't her day.
That was a long song.
It was long and put me to sleep.
Well, it didn't put me to sleep, but... Am I on? Hello? Yep, okay.
Oh, sorry.
Okay, so that was Greg Allman.
Yeah, it was Greg Allman, who just passed away recently.
A couple days ago?
69 years old. Everybody, I mean, I just watched a special on David Bowie, and I didn't. It wasn't a very good one, because they didn't even have much of his songs in it at all. It just had a bunch of people that knew him and talked about him. It's like all this has-been stuff, you know, that all this after the fact kind of stuff. But anyway,
hey, that's on the Capricorn label, and that came from the Capricorn album, Laid Back. That's okay. Where those.
Yeah, it was pretty laid back.
They both came from that.
Yeah, pretty laid back.
1973.
All right.
Now, this is the one you're talking about, and I think I just got this because it hit the charts or something.
No
this
Angel?
This is...
it's not a dance song. It's just a good tune.
I've never played it. It's a Virgin record.
A Virgin.
Yeah.
We're playing a Virgin. We're playing with a Virgin today.
And this is taken from the epic LP, I'm No Angel.
Have you ever had a Virgin? I guess you have one now, right?
I'm not answering that. Well, this is the Greg Allman Band. This was in the wrong place. This should have been in here with these.
Well, it wasn't Allman Brothers Band. It was the Greg Allman Band.
Greg Allman Band. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. That's right. Anyways, this is your song. Brand new.
I'm No Angel. It's a Virgin.
Played.
We're playing a Virgin. Playing with a Virgin. Here it comes.
I'm out crazy.
I know. You spit all over
the
mixing.
No, it wasn't spit.
Spit
it was,
all over the mixing
like a
board.
Rock or something.
A rock?
Oh, look at it. What's that? It came out. I tipped it up.
I don't know.
Out.
You sit over there. I don't.
Ew.
And it's all covered up while you're... Don't put it on a turntable, you jerk.
Right there, look. There you
Whoops,
see it?
Hey, we
you
got
see it. Where'd it go?
No, you can't see it.
Can't
it's
see
right
it.
There.
Yeah, we could take the
oh, yeah, you can. Right in the edge. Right in the edge. Right in the edge there. You can see it.
You don't want to touch
get
it?
Get it out of there.
Right there. There it is.
Can yeah. I take the needle off the record?
Yeah.
Thank you.
What the hell is
get
that?
Get my virgin record out of there.
What the hell is that?
I don't know. It came from your house.
I just went, and it fell, I go like this, and it fell out.
You want to do the other side of this? I like that. That was a good sound.
Yeah, that's what I said. That's
I'll
one
have
of my
to
favorites.
Remember that.
I like Melissa
Lead me on.
From the Allman Brothers Band the best.
No,
but
no, we're not doing that. How, okay.
What do you mean we're not doing that?
Says
who?
Yes.
Okay, we can do this first.
Anyways, here's what I got so you know.
Okay.
Ramblin' Man.
Yep.
Pony Boy.
Never heard it.
Crazy Love. That's a good one, too. Just Ain't Easy. Melissa.
There's
Melissa. Blue Sky. This is a
Blue
Revival.
Blue Sky.
Revival and another Revival. And Straight from the Heart. And, whoops, another Virgin, leaving.
Another virgin. Ooh.
So that's what I got.
We
for
got
the
two,
Allman Brothers
so
band.
So we'll have two virgins in a
row. Two virgins in a row. And that's not the label we're talking about either. Okay.
All right. So side two.
Lead me on. Greg Allman Band. And nothing's. This is also from I'm No Angel. But I like that other side.
Yeah,
that
I
was
do,
good.
I do too. Yeah. What year is that?
They should put it here somewhere. Up here.
Seven, or
87.
87.
Yeah, because this was 73. So that quite a long ways in between there.
Oh yeah.
Well, you could tell by the fidelity too.
Yeah.
Okay, here you go.
All right. Leave me on.
Leave me on.
Baby, you
That's because it wasn't me. Oh, you still can't. I'm kind of in there. That one over here. No, it's that one over there.
It's that one over there. Yeah, it's just quite.
Oh, well.
That's
I thought I adjusted it, but I guess I didn't.
Well, you can. You got plenty of
that
time.
That one's not bad. Look at that. That's that crappy camera. It looks pretty good. What the heck's going on with that?
I didn't switch them.
All right. Anyway, Greg Allman, we're featuring some Greg.
And, okay, now we're going to be going into the
Allman Brothers Band. Okay.
That's all I've got.
That's with Dwayne Allman, too.
Yeah, that's all I've got by Greg and his band. So.
Okay.
Sorry about that, but no, he wasn't my most favorite. He came out with some song. Well, a Ramblin' Man I like, and Greg Allman also.
Sweet Melissa.
He came out, was it all Greg Allman? No, I don't think it was. Greg Allman. I'm thinking I've picked up some real obscure versions of songs, but it wasn't Greg Allman. I'm thinking about, it'll come to me.
Okay.
Anyways, Ramblin' Man.
Okay.
This was a chart record.
I was born a rambling man.
Yeah, and this thing's 5 minutes long, too.
Trying to make a living and doing the best I can.
I've got a 5-second intro.
That sounds like us. Trying to make a living and doing the best we can. We ain't doing shit.
1973. This is the same year that he broke loose with that Midnight Rider.
Okay.
So, I don't know. Were they beginning to split up there or go on their own way or...
Is that
what they did?
I don't know. Like I say, when I saw him was back in 1980 something or other.
Okay, well, this is from the Brothers and Sisters album.
I know that. What year was that?
This is 73, and so was Midnight Rider. This is one of the first ones.
Yeah, kinda. You'd have to look it up and see when Dwayne Allman died, because when Dwayne Allman died is when everything kind of went sideways there for a while.
Ooh, noise. Well, let's see what they got. Allman Brothers Band.
You want to play this first?
No, let's just wait a second here. Just hold on to your bippies. I'm wondering whether they'll go Allman, Help me out here. Allman Brothers Band, The Ramblin' Man, made number 2 in 73.
All right.
Originally released by Allman Brothers Band. The Greg Allman Band. Let's see what it says here. Guitar, Greg Allman. Keyboards, Dickie Betts. Barry Oakley. Duo, Butch Trucks. J-A-I. How do you pronounce that? J-A-I. Johnny Jonathan. Dwayne and Greg, known earlier as Allman Joys and Hourglass. Dwayne was the top session guitarist at Muscle Shoals. Killed in a motorcycle crash on my birthday in 1971, 10/29.
Okay, so there you go. There you go.
At age 24.
Yeah.
Okay, so
I guess he was quite the guitar player.
Yeah. C-level. There's a few other things. Ramblin' Man was their biggest hit. Midnight Rider.
You know, I wonder,
because
he played guitar at Muscle Shoals. I was wondering if any of the stuff that Bob Seger put out, because he used to use Muscle Shoals too.
Okay, here you go. Midnight Rider, made number 19 in 73. Greg Allman, originally released by the Allman Brothers Band on the 1970 album Out of the Wild South.
Okay, so that one has Dwayne Allman in it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. And there's your Jessica, and there's Melissa.
Melissa was done earlier, so that was when Dwayne was
still
with
back him. Up, and then Jessica was after it.
Okay. And it said that Greg Allman was guitar, because I always thought he was keyboard.
No. What does it say here? Greg Allman, keyboards.
Yeah, I thought it was keyboards. Yeah.
Right. Greg Allman, keyboards.
Oogie.
Okay, anyways, we know that. So
Ramble Band,
has
Dwayne on there.
Yeah, now they had Revival, Ain't Wasting Time No More, and Melissa and One Way Out all charted in the 80s and 90s in 1971 and 72. And then Ramblin' Man put them on the charts, made number 2 in 73. And that was basically it, except for Midnight Rider making number 19. The rest of them were all Crazy Love did hit number 29 in 79.
Okay. And
I'm No Angels down here. It's the last thing charted.
Wow. Well, it made
the Greg Allman Band.
10?
No, 49.
Oh, 49. Wow. All right.
But just because you and I like a song doesn't mean it's going to be a hit.
Right.
Which we find happening quite a bit. Well, that was a great song.
That's what
was
I
it
do.
Popular?
What no. I do. I bought another. I brought my Alice Cooper album over at the Groove Records.
Yeah, I know you did. I was there. Oh, did you finally
no,
get
no,
it out?
$10 one. Yeah,
you finally got it
well,
out.
Well, he charged me $6 for it instead of $10. I thought it was in great shape. Was never...
Yeah, and then she wrote $6.
And she wrote $6.
It.
Yeah, we had that story. But anyway,
so on eBay, it just went from $120 to $50.
Yeah,
because somebody wrote $6 on it.
But anyway, so I
shame on you. You don't do that.
I recorded that, and
what'd you record it for? You got a record player? Listen, go back the old.
You can't
old
listen. You can't listen in your car.
What, this will go in the car? It's got battery operated, got a little speaker on it.
I just recorded it, I put it on flash drive, I plug it in the car, and I listen to my Alice Cooper.
You know what you can do with your flash drive?
Yeah. Anyway. So much easier than making a CD. I had to put everything on flash drive. You listen to it for a few times, you delete it, and put something else on.